What is the deal with the parasympathetic nervous system causing bronchoconstriction in the lungs? It seems counterintuitive. Why would your body make it more difficult to breathe? Also, there was some confusion about this idea of dead airspace, and the two concepts are connected. So, the easiest way to show you is to show you. All right. So, let's do two different examples. So, first of all, in terms of dead airspace, imagine that I have to breathe like I am super spy James Bond, and I'm underwater and I'm hiding from bad guys and I'm trying to breathe through a reed, right? So I have a choice. I can either breathe through this reed, like right near the surface of the water, or I can breathe through this reed, which I constructed from a variety of straws, right? So here's a straw that I've constructed, right? So is it better to breathe to be right near the surface of the water with a one straw, or is it better to be way underneath the surface of the water with this long doohickey, right? The problem is that you can breathe through one straw okay, because you can push the air through and back and through and back, but it has to get all the way through and all the way back in order to exchange air with the atmosphere, right? But here I'm trying to exchange air all the way. It looks like I'm smoking a hookah or something. I have to try to get the air all the way through all of this, all the way out to the atmosphere and all the way back, in order to exchange oxygen for carbon dioxide. And if my lung capacity isn't sufficient to push enough air out and all the way back in, then all I'm doing is I'm rebreathing that same air in and out through this same tubing. And that's just dead airspace, right? The tube can only be so long because the average person's lungs can only breathe out and back in a certain amount of tube length. And then after that, you get dead air, right? So that's the idea of the length of the tube. All right, another way you can have dead air, and this has to do with the bronchodilation that I was talking about, is which of these two tubes do you want to breathe through? So again, you're James Bond, or the super sleuthy hero of your choice, doesn't matter who it is, and you're right near the surface of the water and you can breathe through one of these two tubes, okay? All right, so I made the ends of the tubes the same because no matter what, you have to breathe through the same trachea, right? So the diameter at some point in the process is going to be that same diameter. But say you're breathing through these two tubes. Well, again, I'm trying to breathe through this one tube. Okay, my lungs can probably deal with that amount of tubes. It's not very wide, but I could probably deal with that. But here, if I want to breathe back and forth through this, I have to really take deep breaths in and out, because all this is dead airspace, right? Because I got to fill this all the way up, blow it out, then bring it all the way back, and then breathe it back in again. And this is sort of the equivalent of having dilated bronchi. If my bronchi are all dilated, then I'm going to have lots of dead airspace. And that means I'm going to have to be fully pushing my diaphragm up and out and my intercostal muscles and my ribs, right? So I'll be sitting here trying to breathe, and I'll have to be breathing while I'm just sitting here, right? And so most of the time you're not doing that, right? You're doing that when you're trying to run, right? Because you're using more oxygen because your skeletal muscles of your legs are going, right? So running from a bear, right? Or it's fight or flight. So you're trying to run, so you need more oxygen, your heart is pumping faster, you're breathing more deeply, right? You need that extra airflow because you're having more oxygen carbon dioxide exchanged at the alveoli per second because you're using oxygen faster, right? But if you're just sitting there in your normal situation, sitting and listening to a lecture, you're not using oxygen that fast. So you don't need dilated bronchi. You don't need all that dead airspace, right? So you're just. Now, if you were just sitting there listening to a lecture and, now you're forcing your muscles of breathing to use more oxygen than they need to. It's a waste of energy. And that's why the parasympathetic nervous system that innervates your lungs constricts bronchi when you're at rest. Rest and digest, rest and relaxation, parasympathetics, right? That's why you have constriction. So it's important to understand what dead airspace is, because it's important to understand why dead airspace is a problem with emphysema, and also to understand why it is that the parasympathetic nervous system is there. It's important there for everyday life. It's just that when we are treating patients, usually we're trying to give them more oxygen. Usually if they're sick, if everything is too constricted, then you can't get oxygen in the way you want. All right, so I hope that clears up what dead airspace is. I'm going to show the pictures again from that pear deck that I gave everybody, just to show, you know, which ones of those pictures had more dead airspace than the other, just to make sure everybody understands. All right, hope that clears it up.